Good morning to everyone. I express my sincere thanks to the management, principal, and also the IQAC department for giving me this opportunity. Palani College for giving me this opportunity. Also the principal Palani College for giving me this opportunity to talk on curriculum design and its implementation. Now everyone is known, the education is to be executed through the process of curriculum only. What is a curriculum? As per Vivekananda, slide number 1, education is the manifestation of the perfection which is already present in man. That is the core theme of education through which we can execute the curriculum. Now this curriculum in India is based on a particular programs like program of studies, set of practices, set of materials to be introduced, sequence of defined courses, course study methods, and a set of evaluation performance and objectives. Now these are the general strategies which are used in our India. Now in this case, this curriculum is designed based on the informations of social, then information processing, personalized and behavior curriculum. So there are four types of these curriculum are exhibiting for determination of the kinds of curriculum. Now what are the approaches for getting this curriculum? We know pretty well that a curriculum alone designs the process of education. By the process of curriculum only you can impart knowledge. By imparting knowledge you can impart the educational modes. By imparting educational modes over there, then you can get the awards of degree by which the graduation is being approved. Now this is a general process of an educational steps in which the curriculum plays an important role. Now what are general approaches which are given for a curriculum? First one is called the idealism. Second one is called the realism. Third one is called the perennialism. Fourth one is called essentialism. Fifth one is called the experimentalism. Sixth one is called existentialism. And last one is called constructivism. Now all these things are generally determining the approaches for curriculum, in which each idea of from idealism, realism, perennialism, essentialism, experimentalism, existentialism, constructivism, all these isms are a general approach of a common sense. With an idea, there is a reality which is to be perennial, essential, must be done experimental, which should be existed, and finally a constructive structure has to be given. That was the thing for the approach of a curriculum. So our curriculum must be having all these common features. Now what is an idealism? It is the idea through which has a reality. That means, say for an example, an economics subject with a curriculum can be exhibited or can be finalized only with a reality structure. That cannot be sit in an utopian thought and they cannot execute it. So it must be a reality one, which is also called a solipsism. Now this type of structures which are being already present in the reality of a structure. Say for an example, the existence of life below 8 kilometer depth of a sea and anatomy of study of that animal is only an utopian thought, because man can go below the earth to a maximum with the instruments and other things. He has reached only up to 2 kilometers. In that case, reaching an animal at 8 kilometers with depth of a sea and studying its anatomy, if you put it in a curriculum, means it is only an utopian thought. You cannot exhibit it. And the same also, analysis of the organisms which are present in Neptune means that is also an utopian thought, because not even the missions has reached that place. Only the signals, the symbols, everything which is sent by the satellites has been received back, and through which only we have determined that this orga, this planet is like that only. Likewise, getting into the atom and scooping over it is also not possible, because we have studied about the boson particles, which is also to be experimented at a very high level of instrumentation processes in a very secured and vacuumized structures, which cannot be done in a curriculum also. So such a type of unreality structures cannot be found in the normal curriculum. If you want to have such a curriculum, that curriculums must be an extraordinary with the sophistication of structures of your presence. Second thing is called the realism. That means what we observe, what is reality, what we believe as truth, all those things are being considered as reality. Such a reality structure must be present in the curriculum. That means a mathematician who is working on mathematics must be able to exhibit certain formulas and also certain structures. Designing all these things can be only with the purpose of utilization only, which can be demonstrated or which can be exhibited or which can be made draw in a successful manner to explain to the learners. Such a type of reality structures are a thing which is there. The Fibonacci numbers are very interesting. But deriving a problem with the Fibonacci number is only possible in a galaxy study only, which cannot be in a normal level. Because in the world the dimensions are very determined. The size of the earth is determined. My house place is determined. My bus size is determined. My car speed is determined. All these things are determined structure, where the Fibonacci structure numbers cannot be utilized absolutely to the end. So such a type of realistic structures must be there. Examples what would be given for an homemaker or for a paper on the housekeeping or anything can be given with the reality only. It cannot be given in an absolutely non-real basis. That cannot be given in a syllabus. So such a type of structures cannot be in a curriculum. That we call it as the realism. Third one is called the essentialism. Now it is called the student-centered approach, because what is exactly needed for the hour? We know pretty well in the very very late of 1980s, during the after 1984, India has introduced the computers. At that time there were many resistances as coming. How computers can come? Because all these computers is going to spoil the employment. Likewise, there were many shoutings were there. Then, when it come to reality, every college, every university, every educational centers, even a common place of education like library and library sciences has introduced the computers. Because this may becomes an essential future, so that essentialism has to be looked into, that which is must be predominantly student-centered one. I can give a good example today, because nowadays it has now become much more needed through online courses. So this online type of education is coming, means an absolute camera with more pixel studies. then an absolute system which cannot be easily corrupted, an absolute system which provides a much more clarity, an absolute system which can correct itself. All these things are the needs of the hour, which is all essential for a student or a learner approach. We know pretty well previously when we are doing our research like MPhil, PhD and everything, our thesis will be given to some English professor where he will go through initially their spelling mistakes. But now, I am talking about 1980s, 84 and 90s. Now, this type of spelling mistakes will not be occur generally because a researcher predominantly even don't know the spelling but write the correct spelling because the system itself gives a red underline over the wrong spellings. And it also gives the suggestion for this correct spelling. In such cases, these are the essentialism which makes the perfection of the particular type of curriculum by which somebody developed it. Now we are enjoying it. So such type of education or a curriculum which is need of the hour. Digitalization is the need of the hour. Speed of the vehicle is the need of the hour. More type of books referring through the digital is the need of the hour. Much more facility of search results to be coming in a very short period. Exactly the necessary things are to be given. All these things are the one such type of essentialism through which the curriculum must be based on that one. Then next comes to the is the experimentalism. That means we know pretty well the world is continuously changing. That means based on the reality of the experience, the curriculum must be designed in such a manner that is it must be suited for the constantly changing the experiment, the phenomena. That means, say for an example, when we look into the type of atom at the type of Dalton. Dalton gave the theory regarding the atom. He says the last particle or the last undivided structure of a matter is called the atom. That was the thing which has been derived by Dalton, which is called the Dalton theory of atom, which will be studied by chemistry and physics people, particularly by the zoology, botany people in their biochemistry. Now this type of Dalton theory has been upgraded. I will not say it has been defeated, it has been upgraded by the Rutherford theory. Because Rutherford has found out atom is the not the last part of a matter. Atom comprises of centrally a neutron. The neutron is being occupied by the proton and neutron, central nucleus, which is being occupied by the proton and neutron, over which the electrons revolve around it. So, as per the Dalton, the structure of an atom, which he defines as particularly a type of structure which cannot be further broken. Now, Rutherford has come out with a specific structure called a central nucleus. From the central nucleus, it has been the electrons are there revolving round around it. Also, there is a neutron and proton which occupies at the center. So now there are three materials which are called proton, neutron, electron, and there are orbits which are revolving over it, which also makes a structure of an atom. Now that means it has been an expanded structure. Then Hewitt says, then Bose says, finally now it is more number of particles which are being reported in an atom. That means every time a theory which is being proposed or a proposal which is being given must be based on the reality and the experiments, and our syllabus, our curriculum must be based on this alone, has to be synthesized. Then next one is called the existentialism. That means which is called in the view of a reality of what is goodness, what is badness, which is predominantly a personal interpretation. That means buying a thing is a best thing, whereas by taking it from a shop or the theft from a shop is not a goodness, which is generally called as the interpretations are generally called a virtue. That means I am buying a thing by paying the money. I have taken this without the knowledge of the shopkeeper, it is called a threat. Generally, it is called a general code of conduct. But when we look into the structure, that man is a great cutthroat rogue, and this man is having lot of these illegal structures in his shop. From that, a policeman went and he wanted to take away certain things. Without the knowledge of that man, he takes it away. This is also a part of the threat. But we justify it, say that it is for the welfare of the society, he has taken it out without the knowledge of that man. Earlier, by taking something from the shop, we will call it as theft. Here we will say it is the cleverness of the policeman who has taken it so that everybody has been saved. So this is called the existentialism, which is present in the interpretation, personal interpretation. Now our curriculum must be based on this existentialism. That means if you go to the process of an income tax calculation in a commerce subject, and this commerce subject income tax calculation must be based on the existence of the new laws which is being promulgated. Presently, Government of India has come out with the two different types of presence of the income tax structures, the old scheme, the new scheme. Both the schemes are in the existence. Now what we have to do, the thing which you have to do is this existentialism of which is best for the particular client has to be given to the client so that he will be benefited, he will be enjoying the benefits of the government. Such type of structures has to be incorporated into the curriculum. That means the existentialism. We cannot be an thought which has been already existed, which is not at all now present or even present. If something better is there, we have to give that better one, or we have to go for the comparison of these two so that anyone can choose it. In the market, there is any number of vegetables are present of the same kind. Say for an example, the tomato. There will be 10 types of tomato will be present. The one which is required for a person will be taking that one. If I want more soaring tomato, means I will go for the local tomato. If I want more number of fresh, then I will go for a Bengaluru tomato. If I want more medicinal based structure, means an insulin incorporated tomato, I will buy. That is on the basis of the need of a person, they will select the type of vegetable. Same thing is also here. The existentialism of the all the structures of the subject has to be given to one learner, and that should be incorporated into the curriculum, which is an essential one, because he must be given a choice of everything. By the choice of everything only, he will select the thing which is being known to or benefit for him. That is called the existentialism, which is to be given in an curriculum. Then is called the constructivism. Now this is called new experiences, new experiments must be accommodated in our mind. Many of the people, especially the old people, will not accept the modern concepts which are being given to a person. They will say whether it will exist. I cannot do this experiment. I am already accompanied or acclimatized with this particular type of work only. All these things will be arising. Do you know pretty well, when the mobile phone has come, majority has not opted it, because they say it will be costly. Second, it cannot be maintained. Third, it will be I will kept it somebody. Another, some people will say, I have got 3 landline in my house. How can I? That is enough for me. Somebody says, in previous days there is no phone. Because we are living very peacefully. Why we require a phone? All these things are being heard by us. But now, a house is having a minimum of, I am damn sure, a normal house, even he will be a mason or he will be a very person having low income structure, even that person will house will have 3 or 4 phones which are not in use. He will be having at 2 or 3 phones in continuous use. That is the structure. We know pretty well our youngsters, even at this bed with sleeping, even in the bathroom, they will keep the mobile phone. Just given an example that constructivism is a structure, it's a simple process for adjusting to the mental model. What the mental model says, which can accommodate new experiences. Such a type of new experiences model must be incorporated, because this is going to rule the world in future, or it may be vanished. Whatever it may be, this is a new idea. Such a type of a new idea has to be given a part essential for the future studies. That is more required for the purpose of the futurist. That must be given in the constructive room. So these are the general types of, or the reasonings for a curriculum which we have to do. Now what are the types of curriculum which is present? The types of curriculums are a written curriculum, society-based curriculum, hidden or covert curriculum, a null curriculum, a phantom curriculum, a concomitant curriculum, a rhetorical curriculum, an internal curriculum and an electronic curriculum. These are the some of the curriculum which are now existing. There may be many more curriculums will be also available. But I have taken a small number of structures because which are generally common to our curriculum structure. Now first one is the written curriculum. Everybody will know that this is called a formal instruction or the institutional experiences. In the institution, there will be experiences are there. Based on this, there is a written part of the formal. Now it generally requires a document, a text, a film, supporting teaching materials. And these materials must be an instructional one based on the institutional agenda. An institution is having a special agenda. Say for an example, an engineering college will have its own agenda. A medical college will have its own agenda. A commerce college will have its own agenda. And the science college, social science colleges will have their own structure of institution. In such a type, on the basis of the institution, this type of the document, text, films, supportive materials are to be chosen based on the structures of the institution. Such a type of one which is already in a written part, it is called the formal structure. Say for an example, I belongs to zoology, and this zoology must be taught by a particular type of structures. Say for an example, books, specimens, charts. These things are the normal things which we will use. Such type of structures are called written curriculum. Second one is called society-based curriculum. Now this society-based curriculum, which is an informal structure, that means these structures are mainly to educate. What to educate? To educate throughout the life. From where we are going to educate, this education will be coming from the family, will be coming from the peer group, will be coming from the neighborhoods, will be coming from the religious organizations, which will be coming from the occupations, which will be coming from the mass media and other socializing forces. All these things together will daily teach us. Such type of teaching things has to be a society-based curriculum. Say for an example, now we are introducing a structure called a skill-based structure. In this skill-based structure, all the colleges are having a particular paper. Say for an example, in our zoology, we say sericulture, moriculture, fish culture, then apiculture, all these things which we are saying. Every time when we are upgrading, even at the last meeting, we have decided the agencies which are giving loan and other things for this particular sericulture. Subsidies and government facilities which is giving for the sericulture, that we have included. That means this is an experimental one which we learned from the experts when we call for the meeting. They say that a huge number of subsidies are given for sericulture. Why can't we introduce in our syllabus such a type of society based structure, loan in the bank? Then the physics department will be introducing house wiring and also the pump plumbing structures. Engineering college will have plumbing structures and other things. These are society based curriculum. Such type of types of curriculums are called as societal based curriculum. Next one is the hidden or covert curriculum. Now here, which is generally present in the persons or a college or a school, where an institution where the behavior attitude of the teachers, administrative authorities will be imposed on the students. A teacher will impose on a particular structure of his own through his lesson. Say for an example, if I am more interested in the very chill area residing, say for an example, I am more enjoyable to live in Ooty, means I will always praise Ooty wherever it comes across. Say for an example, if there is some institution Pasteur Institute is present in the Kunnur, which is, when I am teaching immunology, means in this immunology the Pasteur Institute is coming, means immediately I will say Pasteur Institute is an excellent place where everybody will be, place is excellent, it will be greenery, and in the type of in the summer everybody will be coming, and it will have more good tea, quality tea you will get it. All these things I will impose because I am admired by a particular place. Such type of hidden type of curriculums will be there. Second is converting the things. Say for an example, if I am not more familiar with a particular country, it may be even near to me, it may be far to me, then I will say that country will be, no man will live. Generally this type of structures has been already given. Everybody will be thinking Africa is a country where there will be poverty alone, but it is not true. Africa is a country which is having good a biomass structure. Africa is a country where more number of mammals are living. When such type of mammals are living, means it must be more greenery. Where there is a river is running which is called Nile, the longest river in the world. When in such cases, how can be it be a poor country or that? But the general version which is being imposed our brain is called the hidden or covert curriculum, which is been already there. Such type of the new education policy which is coming today, this government is just converting all our Indian freedom struggle in a different manner. Such type of different manner modifications are predominantly based on the hidden convert, because they say Ghazni Muhammad has invaded India for 17 times. He won in the 17th time. That means previously 16 times he was being defeated. Who defeated him? Nobody knows. Of course, the historians will know generally. A common man will not know it. Now this type of government which is being introduced in new structure has says first war is there, in which he has won, he has been defeated. Second war, third war, fourth war, in which the winner and loser are being produced. Such type of structures are being there. Now this is one structure which is called in hidden or covert curriculum, by which the values and the things are being pushed into the learner structure. That means this is based on the organizational design. Such type of curriculums are called as hidden or covert curriculum. Next one is called the null curriculum. That means this curriculum does not require any teaching. That means generally it is not essential for the educational experiences are not required. Say for an example, climbing over a mountain by a fat man will take more energy, because in physics there is a law called force is equal to mass into acceleration, ma. Mass into acceleration means a bulky man will have more mass. Acceleration may be common for a tiny man and a fat man, but the energy which is being utilized will be exorbitantly a great difference between these two. Now this will be generally taught as energy spent or force is equal to ma. That alone will be given. But it is when it is been experienced by a person, when he is rising up, one should not be equivalent. That is why in the boxing contest of the anywhere in the Olympics or everywhere in the world, it is been categorized by the weight, 55 kilogram. Wrestling and boxing are being compared with the 50 kilogram, 40 kilogram, 60 kilogram, 65 above kilogram. Likewise, based on the weight, the force which they are exerting will be calculated. Now this cannot be taught in a particular curriculum or anything, but it will be given in another form, such as the weight of a pendulum or weight of a rod, which is being likewise alone it will be given. But this categorization must be utilized by the persons who are being applying over it. Such type of curriculum are called as null curriculum. Then next one is the phantom curriculum, right? That means it is called a predominant metaculture. That means a narrower accumulating the students at a narrower in the generational subculture. That means this generation, previous generation, future generation. There are three structures of generation structures are available. And those generation structures, it should be accommodating previous and the future. Say for an example, a person like me, I have studied completely. When I am doing my FPhil, I have taken a card with me, searching over library throughout Tamil Nadu. From Chennai to Kanyakumari I went. Each library I will sit, I will refer a book, I will take the references from that only. That was my case when I am doing my MPhil at Annamalai University. That was in the year during 1984. Because at that time the computer has come with the typing of